Good evening and welcome. Final Friday night of the regular season. We've got district titles on the line as well as playoff positioning. What a night it was. We start with Lake Travis and Cedar Park turning into one of the best rivalries in Central Texas. Layla Rahimi at Gupton Stadium. Layla, take it away.
Hey, Roger, that's right. You can't ask for much better when two of the top 10 teams in the state in 4A are playing for the district title in the final week of the season. That's exactly what happened at Gupton Stadium tonight. And it was a raucous crowd at Gupton to begin it. But first quarter, Zach Espinoza back to punt. The snap bounces. Zach Strueling makes a tackle, giving Lake Travis a short field. Kicking game was significant in this one. First quarter, Colin Legasse on the direct snap goes 16 yards for the first score of the game as Lake Travis takes a 7-0 lead. LT would add a field goal to make it 10-0. Then it's Baker Mayfield to Legasse, and that's a beautiful connection to make it 17-0 at the half. Second half, Lake Travis opens up with a one-play, 84-yard drive. Guess who? Legasse. Going the distance to open this game up at 24-0, Lake Travis, but Cedar Park would come back. They score later in the third on a short touchdown by Thomas Middleton. Two-point attempt, however, no good. Now, despite a late charge by the Timberwolves, it is Lake Travis who ends up coming away victorious. They win tonight 24-21, the final. But both of these teams really in great position as they get ready for the playoffs. Lake Travis wins that district title at 10-0. However, Cedar Park 8-2. Lake Travis will take on McCallum in the playoffs next week. And as for Cedar Park, they will play LBJ. So two great matchups for both of those teams next week as they may see each other in the playoffs. Live from Gupton, Roger, back to you.
That's right, Layla. We saw it last year with those two schools. To 5A, something on the line in all three games, starting with a district title for Westlake and Bowie. Last year, Bowie won this matchup to force a three-way tie for first in 15-5A with Anderson. Both teams undefeated, 4-0 in district play. Lewis Gilbo, Webb Elliott, and the Chaparrals take control of this one early. And then it is Gilbo again, this time wide open John Rhodes, and he sails into the end zone. And from there, Lake Travis, or rather Westlake on the ground, Bryce Dalzell with the inside handoff, all Chaparrals, they roll to a outright district title, 35-0. Booing go to the playoffs as well. All right, this is where it gets interesting. Anderson and Austin High. Austin High needs a win by six or more to get into the playoffs, and Devontae DeWitty with the touchdown for Anderson. They need a win or keep it within six, and they're in the playoffs. Tied up at 35. Caleb Jones makes it 41-35. The magic formula. Austin High is going to the playoffs with a 2-8 record, 41-35 the final. What about Del Valle? They won their first game of the season last week over Austin High, so they needed a win tonight over Aikens to claim that other spot in 15-5A, and that is Jalen Alfaro takes it into the end zone, and then Alfaro to Darius Threadgill. Del Valle wins, so they go on to play Pflugerville in the first round. Austin High will take on Leander. Meantime, in 15-5A, the Westwood Round Rock matchup for the top seed in Division I out of that district, that would affect Bowie and Westlake. Westwood losing for the first time last week to Leander. How about Dez Wyatt on the punt return? And Wyatt takes it to the end zone. Westwood on their way to their winningest regular season in school history. Ben Johnson to Ryan Leggett for the touchdown right here. Westwood wins it. So Westwood will take on Bowie, and they'll host Bowie in the first round, while Round Rock will take on Westlake in the first round. Conley and Maynor. Maynor looking for a piece of the district championship with Hendrickson. Hendrickson's season is finished. Conley into the playoffs. That's Day Payton with the short touchdown. But how about Maynor quarterback Ja'Cory McQueen? He has turned into a highlight machine. Down to the one, leads to a short Maynor touchdown. And then McQueen into the end zone. And Maynor up by 20 late. Looks like they'll get a piece of that District 16-4A title as they improve to 5-1 in district play. Hutto and Bastrop in Bastrop. Hippos are going to the playoffs, and they can claim a three-way tie with a victory. Ryan Higgins to A.J. Lopez, and then Tay Howard on the ground, and Hutto, Hendrickson, and Maynard all finish at 5-1 in district play. 34-7, Hutto is rolling. How about District 27-4A, Hayes and Smithson Valley. Hayes 4-1, Smithson Valley 5-0. In fact, they're 9-0. Caleb Kimbrough, touchdown for the Rebels. They're all fired up, and then Smithson Valley bounces back. Lawrence Madison into the end zone, but Kimbrough would hook up with Taven Mayberry. And Hayes, what a season under first-year coach Blake Felt. They get a piece of the district title. 34-28 is that final. 25-3A, Lampasas comes in at 4-0 in district play. So Taylor, 3-6, but all three wins in the district, so they can share the district title. Lampasas, that is Secundi Howard with the touchdown, and then Taylor down 14-7. Emmett Wiggins ties it up at 14. Lampasas answers. Marcus Kehoe. Those guys are tough because this was a high-scoring game. Kehoe, the touchdown. And late in this one, Lampasas trying to hang on for the perfect district record and outright title. 58-50 is the score up at Taylor. Once again, the playoffs begin on Thursday around Central Texas. That Cedar Park-Lake Travis game, you can see it in its entirety tomorrow night, 7 o'clock on KBVO.